Hey, Rezonus here, and today I want to share with you how I handle errors at my React app in Creeza.org so that you can find some interesting bits for your project. Let's jump in. If something breaks in the app on production, React will just show widescreen, and that's not something we want. Let's go to the root of the app component and show fallback if something went wrong. Here at the app component, I have error boundary with a full size year fallback. So let's try to comment this part for a second and show full size year fallback so that we can see the UI. If we didn't handle the error on lower level, it means that something new, like a new feature or update, caused a crash. So we don't know the reason. And that's why we want to show a different UI that will prompt user to contact us. So here show that something went wrong and have call to action to reload the page, because in some situation it actually might help. But if it doesn't help, there are a few ways to contact support, and in that case, support is me. So if you clicked on message on Twitter, you could see my Twitter profile. Your boundary component actually comes from Sentry React, but I exported it from a dedicated file so that if something changes and I decided to use different year monitoring, I would still have the same API. For the root fallback, I use full size year fallback. So it's actually a component that takes full size and renders year fallback card on the center. And year fallback card displays that something went wrong. There is a button to reload the page, so we call location reload. Below, we show a support contact. So that's a number of actually links that look like buttons that lead to LinkedIn, Telegram, Twitter. Beside the root component, I also handle errors with the year boundary component on the dedicated pages that are not actually that important, and the app could still work if something inside of the page failed. So for example, here we have an analytics page and I use a year fallback card here. So if we try to comment this part and instead we just show year fallback card, we should see this result. So here we have a title of the page, but inside we use the same component, the same card. Sometimes when I develop a new widget and I want to deploy it as soon as possible, I would wrap it with year boundary without any fallback, so that if it doesn't work, the app still works the same, but there's no widget. The example would be this widget on the focus page. So when you start the focus session, there's focus sounds panel, and if something doesn't work with sounds, it will just disappear. For year monitoring, I use Sentry, and here we have a few functions that I use in the app to check errors. So the first one is setup error monitoring, and I call it at the app. So here we call setup error monitoring. And what it will do, it will check if it's production, and we want to initialize Sentry. So first parameter here is ignore errors, because some errors don't actually break app, but it will clock your Sentry errors list, and in that case, problems with resize observer doesn't really affect the app. So then we provide React app Sentry key. So I use this assert and var function so that I don't access end variables that shouldn't exist in the app. Then we have a few integrations, one for browser tracing and another one for extra error data integration, so that when you have a bigger object like JSON, it will show it. Otherwise, you won't be able to see it. And finally, we set a version of the app. I also use assert and var to get React app version. Also, we have set user ID for error monitoring. So once we receive user ID, it could be available to associate years with a given user. And in that case, we call Sentry configure scope and set user ID. And finally, here we have a report error that receives an error and also a record. So we go over each field in the record and set extra to the scope. That's all. Hope you found something interesting. Stay productive.